Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go through this plugin called Morphine in FL Studio. If you're new here, I need you to smash that like button to extend that S in the intro. So you guys may not understand how this plugin works. It is a really, really well done plugin. And I'll say they have some of the best presets in all of the stock plugins. I learned about this plugin from the mob producers who make West Coast mob music. And basically the basses in here are just amazing. So let's just go through a couple of presets before we get into like the sound design and how to go through all these different windows in here. So we have that like additive synth, you know, it's trying to mimic like FM synth, trying to recreate harmonics of real instruments. So just really good bass. Great for West Coast hip hop. Probably the best bass plugin in FL Studio. Super slept on, by the way. All right, so let me show you guys how this works. Now, they also have keyboard sounds in here, a bunch of dope sounds. I just don't have time to go through everything. Here's my favorite keyboard called Keyboard Crystal EPFG. They have another dope one called Vocal Vowel for West Coast. And they have, I think, strings. They have a cool violin sound. So this plugin is really fire. Firstly, to reset everything, let's go to where it says options. Let's go to reset the program. And when you hit a key, nothing's going to happen. I guess the real reason people don't understand this plugin is because there's no visual cue as to what this like window is doing. This window is situating harmonics. Every sound to its core has what's called a fundamental frequency. So if I left click in here, it creates what's called a sine wave. And this is the beginning of all sounds. What sound really is sine waves at different frequencies. Okay, this is called a fundamental frequency. This is like a basic sub bass. Okay, so that's called a fundamental frequency. So this first vertical line here is a fundamental. That's what generator means. It's generating a sound. It's generating harmonics. Nextly, we can go to the tab next to it. And now we're generating what's called the second harmonic of the fundamental frequency. The math works out this way. If I have a frequency that's at 100 hertz, if my fundamental frequency is at 100 hertz, the second harmonic would be 2 times 100. So in that case, it would be 200. And if I want to add the third harmonic, which would be right here, 3 times the fundamental will be 300. So I'm adding frequencies to the sound. And depending on which harmonic we add, it adds literally another note to the note that we're playing. So you can play multiple notes by playing one note. So we're playing the tonic there. Let's add the second harmonic. Let's add the third. And now it's like, doo, doo, doo. Now we're playing a perfect fifth. Sounds like it. And that's how you get that club type of sound. Now let's add the fourth harmonic. Let's add the fifth harmonic. And this is adding dissonance here, the fifth harmonic. You can hear it's. So what if I told you bass notes that you actually play are really chords? You're playing multiple notes inside of one note. It's not just one note. And that's the cool part about music is that we have notes that are really notes of notes. And then we can play notes of notes called chords. So it gets really complex. So that's what sound is. It's stacking different harmonics. So you can left click and drag to create, a buzzier tone. So the higher the harmonics go, the more metallic and buzzy the sound. So I'm just left clicking. Let me turn this down. Looks like we're clipping here. Hold on, y'all. Now, it thins out the more harmonics you add. Okay, so it will thin out the sound. So if you ever mess up, you can go to here, I believe, and clear. Might be making that up. Reset current view. Okay. And now we can start back over. So I like this tone right here. It's very, Need for Speed-ish. Let's just boost it a little bit. Let's pull this down 12 semitones, which is one octave, and let's add some drive to add some more sizzle to the sound. And we have glide, which adds a pitch bend between the notes. So it's like wow, 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 like that. Like that. The master envelope controls the curvature of the waveform. So a slower attack means it's gonna be like. that's more for like drill, or if you're doing some kind of EDM, you might mess with that attack time. For this sound, we're just going to leave it as is. Let's mess with the glide. Now I want to thicken out the sound. Let's add a little chorus. We're just going to click the button here to turn it on. This has a really nice chorus. We're going to add a subtle delay. I'm just going to pull that down so it's almost undetectable. Let's add a subtle reverb here. And just cut this mix level to about 10%. This is just to give dimension to the sound. So let me show you guys something that you probably didn't know. You could drag samples into here. Now, there may be a way to drag samples into the harmonic generator. I haven't found a way to do that. Maybe there is, but I haven't found a way. So what I'll do is I'll drag a sample in here. I'll drag it into the envelope area. And what happens is this resynthesis area will say uncharge the sample. So right now, there's no sample to charge, I guess load. So let's drag the sample in here. And now it says uncharged sample. Now, if I play a key, we don't hear it. If I hit the test button, you could actually hear it. Question is, how do we activate it? Here under the spectrum, think of this like an envelope, an ADSR envelope. We're going to click the where it says spectrum and import charged sample. And now we have a synthetic sound. I mean, we have a real sound turned synthetic. Okay, so now notice it did take away from our harmonics. I don't know. I'm not sure the correlation between the two. I don't know if this overrides this or what. But I don't hear our original tone anymore. So I assume that this envelope overrides this area. I'm not sure the science behind it, you know, so you guys have to like just understand that. But click here, and then if you guys don't like the sound, we could always uncharge the sample. And we need to right click. Let's see if there's a reset button. Reset spectrum. Okay. And then we have to draw our harmonics one more time. There seems to be a tool here, and I assume that this tool filters out harmonics for us. So let's say you want to make a square wave. You're going to click where it says tool. Let's go to odd harmonics. And now when I left click and drag, it just selects all the odd harmonics so that it saves time with me trying to go through and figure out where, you know, the odd harmonics are. Then I would go to one harmonic and just left click to fade it out, or just right click to get rid of them. Okay, so that's a tool. Let's right click to delete. Let's go to this tool. Let's do even harmonics. This is going to be your sawtooth. But see, it's adding all of the harmonics, so we need to get rid of some of the harmonics we don't want. Let me show you guys a couple more things here. On the right side, we have this control range. Now I'm gonna mess with this. I don't know what it does, but I assume it messes with the voices in this view here. I don't hear it though. So for that reason, I can't conclude what this is actually doing. The pulse width modulator filter. If you turn it on plus mode, we'll hear some phase cancellation. So you're going to hear more of that if we use odd harmonics, because that would be... And we can combine, as you guys just saw, even and odd harmonics. It's a pretty cool sound. And then we have an EQ, which we can further shave off some harmonics here. If it's too bright of a sound, let's turn this on. So we have generator A, B, C, and D. So these all create, you know, harmonics. Let's turn this mode off. And let's just add some kind of sub energy. Now, I don't know how to... Let's see what changes here. I don't know how to make the voice of B stand out. So that's the only tricky part here. Let's also go to the detune window and detune the voices within oscillator A. And it also gives you values right here. So now we're detuning the individual harmonics from each other so they don't just stack in phase. You gotta be very light-handed with that. Yeah, I'm not hearing operator B or generator B, so I don't know how to actually make that be heard. I'll quickly look around, but let me see. It's not very clear. So this is one of the most unclear synths in all of FL Studio. I think we have, okay, here we go. Here's our morph between generator A, B, and D. So it looks like we have to decide using a slider, blending these different generators together. So that's how we get generator B to actually work. And the modulation looks like if we want to create complex mod matrices, like for example, if you want your mod wheel, which would be CC number one to control like some kind of pitch wobble, you could do that. This is mostly CC MIDI or envelope one. Let's see what we can even modulate here. We can modulate the panning. Let's use envelope two. And let's see if we can find envelope two. So let's go back to the main thing. Let's see. So envelopes, not very clear where the envelopes are located. So again, not the greatest interface for navigation here. I will look around for a second here. I assume these are envelopes here to the right. You can right click to create curvatures here. So this looks like modulation for the mod matrix here. So if you want the sound to move from B to A quickly, you can kind of draw in, you can right click. It's not clear what it's doing though, so that is super kind of confusing. All right, so, oh, here we go. Here's the envelopes right at the bottom. I didn't miss, okay, so I did not see this. Okay, so modulation here, we have envelope one, but let's use envelope two in case that controls the amplitude. And let's right click to create a point. So I want the sound to pan from left to right. I want to give it a quick decay curvature. Okay, so now envelope two, it starts left and then it pans right over this amount of time. All right, so hopefully I'm demystifying a lot of what Morphine actually is. As you guys can tell, it's really difficult to get a good sound in Morphine without spending a lot of time. So that's why I respect the presets. Let's try a couple more things. Let's see what an 808 sounds like. If we drag it into the area here, and let's go to import chart sample. Let's go back to our morph area. So this is what it sounds like when 808s cry. No, getting kind of weird. I don't know if we have to make sure that the root note is different. Maybe that's part of the sound. But yeah, I'm not sure how this actually does the science. I'm not sure how many sample points it uses. Let's try to create some kind of loop. Pace velocity, let's normalize. And again, it's not very clear how to create loops either. So kind of right clicking around. So not very intuitive. Kind of weird, actually. Very weird. All right, that is super weird. Delete breakpoints before a loop. I don't even know where the loop is. So for that reason, I can't really recommend the drag and drop sample thing unless you guys just want to really experiment. It's just not doing much of anything. Yeah, this is a pretty dope sound. Let's go to poly. Let's switch this to mono so that we can only play one voice at a time. And then the glide mode, we have to determine how it wants the pitch bend between the notes. So maybe you guys, I think these are loop points right here. Okay, I found the loop points. Here we go. So these little vertical lines are the loop points. I have it on ping pong looping, which should be forward backward looping. I don't hear a crossfade, so I assume it's looping. Let's make this shorter. Yeah, I'm not hearing the looping. Let's try a different style loop. Okay, so it looks like if you right click along this timeline, it pulls up the harmonics for that specific point in the sample. So what it seems to be doing is taking specific points of the sample and then converting it into a harmonic frequency content per the time of the sample. So if I left click and kind of go through, it will show me the harmonics for that specific point in the sample. That's pretty unique. Okay, so that way it's not just a static harmonic stack. But again, I'm not hearing the looping, so for that reason, I have no idea where the loop is or what it's doing. one more thing before we just give up on this loop. Okay, so it could be looping. It's just hard to tell. All right, so that works for bass because you want bass to be seamless. Let's try some more. Let's do maybe a one shot. Let's see if I even have a pack. Where's my pack? Here we go. Boom. Let's try like a bell, and then let's load this up. Now that sounds like a bell. Okay, now that sounds like the actual sample. It's a little slowed down, but it sounds like the sample. Now I want to see if we switch the tempo. That doesn't do much. Alright, so again, from here, you guys can experiment. But that is how Morphine is used. Again, it's probably best you guys just run through the presets. You could tell here they dragged in samples though. That's why this area says uncharge the sample. So most of these seem to be sample based, unless that's my bell. Actually, I'm wrong. That's not right. Incorrect what I just said. All right, so just try it out, guys. That is the demystification of Morphine. I'm sure you guys could geek out on specifics, but that's pretty much the gist. And it looks like I missed over here. There's a loop mode over here that we could use, and then a noise sample area where we could load up noise. All right, so I missed that just in talking, but I'll let you guys experiment. If you want to learn more, go to busyworksbeats.com. I have a free FL Studio 21 course. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. Subscribe if you're new. Peace out, guys.